In this video, we're taking a look at some great songs with terrible music videos.
First off, we have Britney Spears' Make Me featuring G-Eazy. One of Britney's more recent songs, but it still features a killer hook. The music video features some killer cringe.
What was your name again?
Michael.
I feel like we need to see more of you.
More of me?
Yes.
Like here right now?
No, later on.
Saturday.
Yes, yeah, Saturday. Yeah.
Like multiples of you.
Yeah.
Good looking friends.
Yeah.
Right?
Seems like the opening to an adult movie, but with even worse acting for some reason.
Saturday at 1. We'll see you there.
Bye, Michael.
Bye, Michael. Call your friends.
Bye, Michael.
Now that was hilarious.
I'm dreaming of my limit about somebody. This feeling, I want to go with it, cause there's no way. Oh, hiding away from this tonight.
Oh, that's such a sick chorus. But yeah, what is this music video? Are these like shirtless models auditioning for them? Who came up with this idea? This is awful. I'm cringing so hard. That was very cringe, very bad, and the song is sick. We gotta shame the director, right? David LaChapelle, shame on you. Next up, we have Kiss, Lick It Up. The music video features the band trying to look cool to impress some post-apocalyptic women having a barbecue. Maybe there is something built-in cringy about having a group of people trying to impress another group of people in a music video.
Yeah, yeah.
Wow. Okay. This is like a prehistoric car wash. It's so poorly done. Him. And he looks like Michael Cera here. What is going on? Yes! No! They can be self-aware to a certain extent, but also, that hurts. Wow. I love that song too. By the way, welcome back to another daily video. My name is Joel from Roomie Official, and if I made videos on corn, I would make it on popcorn. You know what I'm talking about? Because I make videos about pop music.
Whoa, jokes!
Next up, we have Toni Braxton's Unbreak My Heart. Braxton's lover dies from a not that serious looking accident. She then spends her time crying and remembering how muscular he was. What? That sounds so weird. Why did every music video from like the 70s have women without bras? Wasn't the Kiss music video as well?
Weird.
Wait, what? Wait.
Don't leave me in all this pain.
This is such a great song too. I love this song. I thought this song was about something really deep and important, but now that I see this, it just feels like it's all made up.
Don't leave me.
Amazing voice. Is that their best memory of him?
Him being shirtless, like.
Also, this song is not about someone dying. It's about someone leaving you.
Unbreak my heart. Say you love me again. Undo this hurt. Cause when you walked out the door and walked out.
I remember when you were swimming.
Take back that said a word goodbye. Bring joy to my life.
What is this?
Don't leave me here with these tears.
It's just so poorly done and acted and planned. All of it just, oh.
My heart, say you love me again.
This might be the worst one. This is so bad. Yeah, that's pretty dope. For our next great song with a bad music video, 5 Seconds of Summer, Youngblood. Great song, boring, lazy, live tour music video. Oh, that's like my least favorite type of music video as well. She's like, yeah, we had someone film a little bit when we're touring. We'll be backstage drinking a soda. And that's the music video.
Remember the words you told me, love me
Instagram filter.
I die.
Surrender my everything, cause you made me believe you're mine.
Yeah, this is boring. I like this song so much, it's so annoying. He sings like a crazy person. Young blood, so you want me back in your life, and I'm just a dead man walking tonight. Love that melody, and just the vocal texture is amazing. Young blood, so you want me back in your life, so ooh, breaking news. 4 months after the release of the original music video, 5 Seconds of Summer released a new proper music video and retitled the old one to Alt Version instead of Official Video, presumably after complaints from fans. Oh, okay, yeah, this is proper. Take the blue pill. Wait, what? Are they...
Yeah, you used to call me baby, now you're calling me by name.
Oh, that's such a cool concept. Looks so much like the guy from BuzzFeed, right? Try guys, Eugene. But you need it, yeah, you need it all of the time, yeah. Very cool music video, but too bad that they weren't in it. Directed by Frank Borin, the video was filmed in Tokyo and tells the story of an elderly couple in their final moments having a flashback of their youth, where they are played by Japanese artists Johnny Daigo Yamashita and Misaki Ayono, which then dives into the Japanese rockabilly culture. I didn't know that was the thing. By the way, have you streamed Living for That on Spotify today? Check it out, it's on Spotify, a little pitchy. What a song, just unbelievable. Here we got Cheap Trick, Up the Creek. Great rock song, but this quote from lead guitarist Rick Nielsen says it all. The video was the worst we've ever done. We've done some bad, bad one, but that one took the cake. Okay, so this is kind of the opposite of the Britney Spears music video. Oh yeah, I'm fishing for models. It's so dumb. Here we got Demi Lovato, Heart Attack. Not necessarily terrible, but it falls very flat for what it could have been. During the chorus, where the energy is at its highest in the song, the camera spends a lot of time still on a tripod, and Lovato's dance moves and energy aren't enough to compensate. Yeah. I can see what my editor means here. It's a very technical, very editor-esque thing, but yeah, for sure. It's not as dynamic as it would have been with more movement. It still looks very good, and some of the themes are cool. And every time I try to be myself, it comes out wrong like a cry for help. It's just not. Oh yeah, that is awkward. That feels like a YouTube music video right there. I shouldn't be talking about awkward music videos. Whenever I start making my own, look forward to some freaking awkward stuff. I'm gonna have to be like self-aware somehow. Yeah. Yeah, it's not good. It's definitely not the worst, but it could have been a lot better with some more movement. I feel like every Taylor Swift music video has like a cut every second to make sure that no awkwardness slips through. And they probably shoot multiple days because she dances awkward, I dance awkward. She's one of my breed. Here we got Journey's Separate Ways, Worlds Apart. While not as big of a hit as Don't Stop Believing, this is still one of Journey's biggest songs with impressive lead vocals from Steve Perry. The music video, however, is not as impressive. Oh, we've seen this one before. This one is bad. Ugh. We showed this one in this video. Here we stand. Worlds apart, hearts broken in two. Two. So impressive. They shot his face from three angles. That deserves 10 seconds. And all that fake playing. Specifically, drummers playing without an instrument looks so dumb. Ooh. It reminds me of the Kiss music video as well. I feel like this was just a thing back then for the whole band to walk and be awkward together. It's charming in a way because you didn't really need to be good at performing per se to be a successful band back then. At least not without your instruments. Ooh, they planned that the other people in the band kind of moved back there a little bit. Next up, we have Katy Perry's Birthday. The official music video for Birthday has about 4 times less views than the lyric video. In the video, Katy dresses up as several characters and has been critiqued for leaning into stereotypes. I love this song though. Wait.
My name is Goldie because of my golden nuggets.
I have a birthday party entertainer. I do bar mitzvahs, I do weddings, I don't do funerals, but for a price, I'll do your funeral. Did you hear about the rabbi who did free circumcisions? He only did it for tips!
We're already kind of in very risque political territory here.
I'm not really a birthday party entertainer. I'm just trying to get some cash on the side.
Unfortunately, I do look like a Papa Smurf right now. I ran a petting zoo facility, but I think that I've officially lost my license.
I am Manny Rogers, aka Lil_.
I don't know what people think that they should put a bunch of random stuff in their music videos. Like, half the people who watch a music video just want to listen to the songs. And then if the video is good, that's great. But like, having a bunch of talking and stuff in a music video doesn't make that much sense. The clock is ticking, running out of time. Such a sick song though. This will make it so that kids can't watch it in front of their parents either. There's so many things wrong with this. So I assume the whole prank thing is also just a setup. It's just not very funny, is it? Oh, of course, talking over the song.
Oh my god, is it really Katy Perry?
That's also what I like in my music videos, some kids screaming. That's why I don't go to concerts. I would love to see some of the big male singers live, like Shawn Mendes or whatever, but I know that there will be just thousands of little girls screaming at the top of their lungs. I'll be like this throughout the whole concert. I'll just like, no, not going.
I'll watch it on VHS later, okay?
Here we got Carly Rae Jepsen, Cut to the Feeling. While not her biggest song, Cut to the Feeling is still a strong, beautiful song that suffers from a lackluster video that looks like someone put it together on Windows Movie Maker. Oh yeah, because they're doing the 80s thing. I had a dream, or was it real? We crossed the line and it was on. We crossed the line, it was on. That filter. This song is so good. So what is this? Oh yeah, what happened to the frame rate here? What?
I think someone should sign that girl to a record contract because she is so good. She's just...
Why does it look so bad? And what's going on here? They're making it ugly on purpose, but it doesn't go all the way. You can't save this with being self-aware. Apparently, this counter has been counting down to when the actual music video starts for real. Very cool. Then the rest of the video is cool, apparently. Okay. Oh, that's sick. Wait, so the music video started in the middle 8. That's like more than half the song gone. It's a little bit static, I would say. I love that song, by the way. That might be my favorite Carly Rae Jepsen song. I think it's better than Run Away With Me. Fight me in the comments. And definitely better than Call Me Maybe. We didn't even have to talk about that. Here we got Survivor's Eye of the Tiger. One of the best rock songs of the 80s, and a huge part of the success was due to it being the theme song for Rocky 3. The music video features the band walking the streets while singing and then playing on a stage that eventually gets soaked with rain. Not exactly the visuals you expect when you hear Eye of the Tiger. I love this guy. He's my favorite already. Is that the singer, the guy in the middle? He looks cool. Rising up, back on the street. They're just walking. Just love this guy so much. I just want to look at him all the time. Straight out of a computer science lab. I think this is computer science guy. What'd he do with his glasses? It's a great song. The water. Okay, guys, click here for more music commentary videos. Click here for music VS videos. And I will see you tomorrow in another
daily video.
Now I'm gonna show you what a good music video looks like. When we're